हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज श्वेता रॉय। दिस वीडियो इज फॉर चैप्टर 6 पार्ट 1 हिस्ट्री, द रिवॉल्ट ऑफ 1857। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉजेज ऑफ द रिवॉल्ट। इन दिस वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट पॉलिटिकल कॉजेज, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव कॉजेज, मिलिट्री कॉजेज, इकोनॉमिक कॉजेज। सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो। The expansion of British territories in India and their policies had adversely affected all sections of Indian people, whether it is the Raja, the Nawabs, the landlords, the sepoys, the peasants, everyone was adversely affected. As you know, the Britishers came in India for trade purpose, for the purpose of trade. Their sole purpose was trade. But later on, by the mid 19th century, they formally established their political control. Now, the resentment among the people had found expression in a number of protests, outbursts, mutinies, rallies, and revolts, which was prior to 1857. Now, some of the important among them were the Second Munda Rising, 1820-37, the Sanyasi Revolt, 1770, the Santhal Rising, 1855, the Revolt of Farizis, 1838-57, the Wahhabi Movement, 1830-60, the Waghera Rising, 1818-19, the Mutiny at Vellore, 1806, the Mutiny at Barakpur, 1824, the Bareilly Rising of 1816 and the Mutiny of Govindgarh Regiment, 1850. So these are some of the important among them. Mutiny is actually an open rebellion which is against proper authorities, especially by soldiers or sailors. And when you talk about revolt, revolt is a rebellion of people against the established authority and power. But the term revolt and rebellion can be used synonymously. So you can see the difference between mutiny and revolt. Mutiny is a rebellion against proper authority by soldiers or sailors, whereas revolt is done by the people. Now this revolt of 1857, it began as a sepoy mutiny, but gradually it took all sections of people. That means all sections of people joined this revolt. Now as per the V.D. Savarkar and several Indian nationalists, the revolt of 1857 is often referred to First War of Indian Independence. As per Ashok Mehta, the rebellion of 1857 was more than a mere sepoy mutiny and was an eruption of the social volcano wherein many pent-up forces found vent. After the eruption, the whole social topography had changed. The scars of the rebellion remained deep and shining. This was the statement by Ashok Mehta. Now we will discuss about the causes of the revolt. So there were a number of causes which led to this revolt. So first we will discuss about the political causes. So there was subsidiary alliance system and doctrine of lapse, which was introduced by the British for annexation of states. And this caused unrest among the rulers of India. Now the rulers of Hyderabad मैसूर तंजोर जोधपुर जयपुर बूंदी भारतपुर वेर फोर्स टू एक्सेप्ट द सब्सिडरी अलायंस सिस्टम. नाउ द स्टेट्स ऑफ सतारा संभलपुर जयपुर भगत उदयपुर झांसी एंड नागपुर दे वेर अनेक्स्ड अंडर द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लैप्स. ओध वॉज अनेक्स्ड ऑन द प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ मिस गवर्नेंस एंड दिस नियरली बाय दिस नियरली ऑल रूलर्स केम अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ कंपनी. सब्सिडरी अलायंस वॉज अ सिस्टम डिवाइज्ड बाय लॉर्ड विलेस्ली इन 1798. Now the princes of states, they were denied of their rights of succession. The company did not recognize the adopted son of Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi as the heir to the throne after her husband's death. Now the Nawab of Karnataka and Tanjore, they lost their royal titles. The pension which was given to Nana Sahib and the adopted son of Peshwa Baji Rao too, that was denied and they were forced to live in Kanpur, far away from his ancestral place in Pune. The Muslim feelings also had been greatly hurt because the names of Mughal kings were removed from the coin which was minted by the company. There was an announcement from Lord Dalhousie in 1849 after the death of Bahadur Shah Jafar that his family would have to leave the Red Fort and reside in some other place which will be given by the company in Delhi. Now Lord Canning declared in 1856 that after the death of Bahadur Shah Jafar his successors would not be recognized as kings. They will be recognized as princes. The harsh policies of British, which was against thugs who used to who lived by the plunder, and irregular soldiers of the native armies had filled them with anger and resentment, and in a revolt of 1857 they fully supported the rebels. Then we have administrative causes. In administrative causes, all the higher posts, which was under civil and military services, they were reserved only for the British. And this caused anger among the aristocratic Indian class. They were actually deprived of power and position. No higher position will be given was given to the Indians. Now the chances of promotion of Indians in civil and military services were very few and negligible. The highest post for an Indian in military was that of a subedar, and in civil services it was of a sadar amin. So these were the post, and above this there was no promotion for Indians. Now we will discuss about the military causes. There were new rules like crossing of the sea, which was introduced by the British, and it hurt the religious sentiments of the sepoys. In those days, crossing the sea meant losing one's religion and caste. When the sepoys were asked to fight for company in Burma in 1824, they refused to go by the sea. They preferred going by the land route. Now in 1856, the company had to pass a new law, and according to that law, they made it compulsory for the army person to go overseas whenever required. Now the Indian sepoys, who were mostly belonged to the villages and with agricultural backgrounds, they fully supported the peasants in the revolt. Then we have economic causes. Now both the peasants and the zamindars were dissatisfied with the revenue policy of the British. As you know, there were high taxes and as well as the harsh methods for revenue collection was implemented by the British, and they were against these methods and the high taxes. Now in the newly acquired territories, the British had totally ignored the landlords, and they established direct contact with the peasants. Now the peasants, who were unable to pay a high revenue, had to either lose their land or fall prey to the money lenders, which made their condition pathetic. Large areas of lands were confiscated and sold by auction to the highest bidders. Also, there was decline of Indian handicrafts and industries, which resulted unemployment and caused discontent among people. Apart from this, we also have social and religious causes and immediate causes. So when we talk about social and religious causes, the British considered themselves as superior to the Indians, and they described the Hindus as barbarians and the Muslims as cruel and intolerant. Also, the British officials often assaulted and insulted the Indians publicly and were let off with little or no punishment. The Christian missionaries tried to convert the Indians into Christianity, and the Britishers fully supported them. They provided extra facilities to them and supported them. In 1850, a new law made conversion to Christianity easier. These British were against idol worship and condemned Hindu gods and goddesses. Also, they taxed the lands belonging to the Hindu temples and Muslim mosques, which hurt their religious sentiments. The British made efforts towards the spread of English education, widow marriage, and legislation against the practice of sati. And these acts were regarded by the Indians as direct interference in their religious and social lives. Now there was immediate cause. In 1856, the British government introduced a new rifle, and this rifle was called Enfield rifle, which was for army. Now this rifle had a greased paper which was attached round the cartridge. Now to load the rifle, a sepoy had to bite off the paper with his mouth. And in 1857, a rumor spread that the greased cartridge was made from the fat of pigs and cows, which deeply hurted the religious sentiments of both Hindus and Muslims. Now the sepoys refused to use the new rifles and decided to revolt. This incident gave the necessary spark to the fire of anger and discontent burning in the hearts of Indians. So these were some of the reasons for the revolt of 1857. To check your progress, we have a question over here. Imagine yourself to be an employee of East India Company. What will be your reaction against their operation? I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.